Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you.
There are many ways to communicate in the late 1800s, but communication through phones was not one of them. For example, the Pony Express was a monumental way of transportation of mail and other news. The Pony Express was very essential back in the day, but it was also a very slow way of communication. People wanted a better way to communicate, so things that were urgent wouldn't take so long to get to others. For example, during the Revolutionary War, some things took too long to send by horse, so people began thinking of a better way to send messages. Then the train was invented. People could use trains for transportation of messages and people.
The idea of transmitting human voices through an electronic device was conceived by Alexander Graham Bell while he was visiting his deaf mother and grandmother. At age 16, Bell began researching the mechanics of speech. The following year, he and his father created visible speech in which they used to teach deaf children. The telegraph was a machine that transmitted electrical clicks over long distances, but he wanted to turn the clicks into human voices. His desire to create this invention became a persistent obsession, but led to the discovery of transmitting voices over great distances rather than electrical clicks. His research showed that human speech moved in wave-like patterns, and he hoped to produce an electrical wave with the same patterns but as a person's voice. In 1875, he came up with a simple receiver that could turn electricity into sound. He was awarded a U.S. patent for it on March 7th of 1876. 3 days later, he actually transmitted speech, and to his assistant in the other room, he spoke his famous words,
"Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you."
After the telephone was first released, it was mainly used by large businesses who needed it for business deals and opportunities. They were primarily used in the sales and business world, but not often for personal use like you see today, says Craig Jones, an industrial design instructor at the Art Institute of Philadelphia. In 1888, the telephone was officially released to all of the public, and by the end of the year, many were sold. After Bell's telephone came out, people communicated via switchboards. They were devices that connected several lines at a time. Switchboard operators answered incoming calls and directed them to the person whom the caller was dialing. The Strouder telephone followed it in 1891 and had the ability to dial out without going through an operator first. In 1925, the first Frankfurt Bauhaus was released, which is the rotary telephone most people are familiar with. Then, the Motorola, the first handheld phone, was released in 1973. They were the first company to mass produce a mobile phone. In the 1980s, they became widely available and very popular. By this time, IBM Simon had created the first touchscreen. A couple years later, in 1992, Nokia launched its first model. This was a big step in the telephone industry because it had access to the global system for mobile communication.
The telephone adapted significantly in 2007 when Apple introduced the smartphone, which changed the telephone industry forever.
Three things: a widescreen iPod with touch controls, a revolutionary mobile phone, and a breakthrough internet communications device. An iPod, a phone, and an internet communicator. An iPod. A phone. Are you getting it? These are not three separate devices. This is one device. And we are calling it iPhone.
Since then, smartphones have come a long way. iPhones, Samsungs, and Google Pixels are some examples of smartphones that have been introduced to the public eye. Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, and many other apps are all ways people can not only communicate, but they can share their pictures and thoughts to the rest of the world. Other than social media platforms, there are games to calm your boredom, apps to track your fitness, apps to make transactions, watch news, edit, and basically anything else you could think of.
By this time, people had realized the advantages of having a phone, and they were very popular. Many more telephone companies rose and then fell because of the competition. Since Apple launched its first iPhone, it and other companies have made huge advancements. The first iPhone had a 3.5-inch diagonal screen
320 times 480 pixels and a 2 megapixel camera. It was 2G, which meant it didn't have little to no capability of connecting to different networks. The second iPhone was 3G based, which meant it could connect faster to networks. It had the same physical appearance, but gained a built-in GPS, location services, and more storage. With new generations came new and improved iPhones. Today, we have gone from the iPhone 1 to the iPhone 12, and it has incredible new features. FaceTime connection as much as 3 times quicker, a higher resolution, Siri, motion data processor, 3D touch, wireless charging, Face ID, water resistance, and 5G networking are just a few of the advancements in the iPhone. Other companies have followed with similar features, for example, Samsung releasing its Samsung Galaxy G flip phone. These futuristic designs have come in an unimaginable way.
Alexander Graham Bell took our distant world and turned it into one in which we are all connected. He ended several problems in our world, from business trading to medical emergencies. Our world is now more technologically advanced than ever, and it all started in a small cabin with Bell and his assistant.